Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Julie Summers and this is A Wild Summers Homeschool. If you're new here, I am a homeschool mama of two wonderful kids and they are 6 and 8 years old. And today I have a couple of updates for you guys and then I have a mini haul that we did. So let's get started. First of all, the first update that I want to show you guys is we did the Walk for Life. I was not permitted to photograph or do any videos while we were there, but I did get a picture of our team together, which what I will insert right here. There was 5 of us moms, and out of the 5 of us moms, we had 11 children that were present, but a lot of the kids did not want to be in the photo. So, and also for the privacy of the other moms, because they knew that I would be sharing the photo. So, that's why you didn't see a lot of the kids in that photo. But that was the photo that we took of the moms team that we got together and did. So our grand total was $253 going directly to Hope Pregnancy Center. So yay! Yeah, it was really, really fun. We all got these awesome t-shirts that say Love Always Hopes on them. And I love mine. Mine has stuff on the back of it too. I think a couple of the t-shirts didn't have stuff on the back. Like, I know our friend Liam, his t-shirt didn't have anything on the back of it. So I think they had different t-shirts for the men. Because he's 17, so he got a t-shirt as well. So they may have had a different t-shirt for the men. I'm not sure. His was the only one that was different than ours. So I thought that was interesting. But it was definitely so much fun, and we did one point eight miles. So it was almost 2 miles for the entire loop. It was really awesome. I would do it again in a heartbeat. It was just amazing. So that's my update on that. The next thing I had for you is a mini haul. We went to the Goodwill. We went, of course, it's the beginning of the month. We went shopping for my mom. But then we also went to the Goodwill store and Dollar Tree. So at the Goodwill store, I found all these logic games. So I found this one. It's a Brain Bogglers, I guess is what it's like. Set 2. And it makes a lot of noise. And my son is loving these. It's so interesting. But anyway, it has like a special way you put these together or take them. I don't know how to do it. Okay, they have this happy face on them. I like it. Okay, there you go. So you take them apart or like put them back together depending. There's 5 different activities in here. Let me see if I can grab another one that's still together. Like there's one. And they're all metal. And while we are having our morning time, I can give him a set and his sister a set and they can figure out how to play with them while I'm reading them our book of the day, which has been going really well, but sometimes they get a little bit like distracted, so I'm hoping those will help with that. I also picked up this really fun, this is the second one of these I found, which is awesome, but it's called a backflip. And so, like, you start on this side, and then you get down to here, and you have to turn it over, and then you bring it up to here, and you have to turn it over to go down to the next one. So you have to flip it back and forth on these puzzles. You don't just go through to the end. You have to flip it back and forth, which, again, logic puzzles are amazing. And the kids are just really, they played with this in the car all the way home. They took turns, and I don't think they got to the end. They just thought it was the greatest thing ever. The next logic thing that I found was this game, which I think is gonna be really fun. And I got it at the Goodwill for $2. $1.99, obviously. And then the point of it is to like get from here all the way to the one that's directly across from it, make a path like a maze. So I figured we could use this as a single player game, just letting them put them wherever they wanted to, or we can use it as a competition game to see who can put the final piece in for the pattern to go all the way across, which would be kind of interesting, actually. The next thing that we got at the Goodwill is I found this shirt for my son, and then I have another one like it for my daughter that are both their sizes, so they have some identical shirts. And we've actually visited this church several times, First Baptist Church of Clarksville. So I thought that was kind of neat. And then even though we just finished our ocean, there's a little hair on there, our ocean adventure, we found these at the store at Goodwill. Again, we found that one and that one at the Goodwill. And they're sea turtles and they're just adorable. I mean, that's just adorable. It's, my son said it looked like a Squirtle. Like, and I guess you could say it looks like a Squirtle, so he was all about that. And this one's just so cute. And it's like so squishy. So it's got like that, I don't know what that feel is, but it's just, the texture of it's amazing. It's so squishy. And I just love the pattern and stuff. And my daughter was just like, Mom, can I please have it? Got it up to the register, and this one was $1 and this one was 50 cents. So let's make it ride that way. So that's pretty awesome. I'll take that. So yeah, they each got to spend a little bit of money on a toy. And then I always try to hit up like the wooden things, the wooden items. And we were going through there and my son spotted this little Indian. And he's had his arms removed, but I still think he's really cool. We're coming into fall and Thanksgiving and stuff, so next month in November, we actually have several Thanksgiving theme units, mini units that we're going to be doing. We're going to be doing Squanto. We're going to be reading that. And then we're going to be reading about the pilgrims and how they came here and stuff. And then my daughter found these. It's a little pilgrim boy and girl, and they're made of wood, which I am super excited about because I love wooden toys. They last ages. So they'll be able to play with these for years. Like, and they never break. I mean, wooden toys just very rarely break. And they're just a little matching set of a girl and boy. So we looked all over the place to see if we could find another little Indian that matched the Indian, and we couldn't find one. So we're going to use those when we learn about Squanto and we learn about the pilgrims and that kind of thing. So that was really awesome. And then, let me show you this. We got this for my mom because we call her Nana. And every time like she walks through the kitchen, the kids are like, Nana, I'm hungry. Even if they just ate, they'll be like, Nana, I'm hungry. Will you make me something? They always tell my mom that she makes the best food on the planet, which she does. She's a really great cook. But I just loved this sign. It was so cute. And it was $1. So that was awesome. So, I even have a spot already. She's seen it, and it had the only thing that's wrong with it is like the corner right there has come loose, and like it's not there. So I can take a little bit of green paint and like paint that over, and nobody will care, or just leave it because you can't really tell. So that's just for $1, and it's so appropriate for my mom. It doesn't matter what time it is. She's gonna fix them something to eat if she thinks they're hungry. So the next thing that I got is this little, I don't know what they're called. They're like those, I mean, it's coming loose on the inside here. Like, it's coming loose. I'll have to super glue that back. There's like an overstuffed lap pad. I don't know. Like, I've seen people use it for like coloring books and stuff. But I told my daughter, I was like, you can have this, and you can put your coloring pad here, or you can put your work pad here, and you can use this, and she's already eaten dinner on it, which is kind of gross. And you can use this area for either a cup, or you can put your marker caps on it, you know, put your marker caps in it, because she's always losing the caps to the markers. So I thought that would be neat. And it's like super overstuffed, but I don't care. It'll be awesome for her. She's already decided she loves it. So that's cool. And then let me lean down here and grab the other two items that we found at the thrift store. I also found a couple of dresses and some things like that that, you know, you guys probably wouldn't even care about. I found this and it's brand new. And I was just like, dude, that's cool. It was $3. It was $2.99. And it was full price, but I went ahead and paid the full price anyways. But it had never even been opened until we opened it a little while ago. But it has all the dice. It has 6 dice that go with it. What else goes with it? It has all these cards. Let me put that back down in there where it's supposed to be. It has, it has a regular numbers dice also. But it has 6 of these letter dice. It has all of these cards right here. I think that's directions and note, and the notepad rather. And then these are all cards that say random things like, let me just get one out for you. It says, work together to complete the challenge. Roll the dice and start the timer. Come up with as many monster names as you can think of. So that was neat. And it has a timer that goes with it, and it has cranium putty, which I think is basically Play-Doh. So yeah, and it was sealed. Like, it looks like a brain. And the kids figured out very quickly that this is like the perfect size for a hat. Of course, it's not gonna, it kind of fits my head. It doesn't really fit my head. But it's definitely the perfect size for a hat for my kids, which is so funny, like, to see them do it. And then the next thing I found a chair to go with our little activity table that I got for free. So this chair I paid $2 for, and the table that has the Mickey Mouse on it, I think you've seen it in one of my other videos. Anyway, it's over there in the corner, and I got it for free. So that was kind of awesome. So I got a chair and table for my activity center. I can't talk tonight, oh my goodness. A chair and a table for my activity center. That would be where they do busy bags, play little games, logic games, and they use file folder games. That's what they do in that corner of the room. And I got the chair for $2, and we had the table that a friend of mine gave to me for free. So that wound up being really awesome. And then I went to the Dollar Tree because it is right near our Goodwill. And I picked up this cute little harvesty decor, it says. So I thought it was cute. My daughter picked it out. And I mean, typically I would take the flower off of it, but she really loved the flower and it caught her eye. So I got that at the Dollar Tree. Paid $1 for it. And then the reason why I went into the Dollar Tree in the first place was to get some more of these, because we have a busy bag exchange coming up. And I love, it's just a piece of paper that I will give my kids to draw on. But I love these because they're clear. Like, I mean, I know they have the dots there, but the other side is completely clear. Let me see if you can. There you go. Yeah, you can see it. This side is completely clear, and they're actually quite big. Like, I can put my whole hand in there, and actually both of them, and have plenty of room. So I will be using these to put busy bags in after I receive them, because I don't like leaving them in the Ziploc bags. I've found that the kids will just throw the bag away, and since I don't have extra Ziploc bags in my house, that's not a good idea. So I did buy 6 of these. I bought 2 pink, 2 green, and 2 of the blue. And then my mom came in and she was like, they had purple too, why didn't you get some of those? And I was like, I didn't see any purple, or I would have. So I got 6 of them. I know that we are getting 30 items in the busy bag exchange, but some of the moms are like me and they like to have them in this, so they actually bought some of these to put them in. Put the items that they're giving away in. So I will see how that goes. I probably will go back and buy more of those. They had a bunch. And then on the way home, I had to stop and get some chicken for dinner. So as I was walking down the aisle coming back from getting the chicken, which is all the way in the back of the store, of course, at my Dollar General, I found these cute little wooden ornaments. Let me move it to the side so you can see what it is. Like, that one is a couple little mouse friends. And then on the back, it has another ornament, which is a little pumpkin with a mouse in it. And since we're doing harvest as our theme for this month, I thought this was so appropriate. And then on this one's more like Thanksgiving. But we will color them during harvest time as well. So that one's like a little turkey with a horn. And this one says, thanks so much. And it's some little pumpkins. And they only had one of these, or I would have gotten more, because I really like this thanks so much ornament. But yeah, I thought they could color these front and back, and then we would hang them on our Christmas tree, because we are only doing wooden ornaments on our tree this year anyways. So I thought that was awesome. And that's basically what I have for you guys today. Like I said, I just went to the dollar store and to get groceries. So I didn't really mean to do a haul video today, but it wound up being a mini haul, because I got a lot of kids stuff while I was, I couldn't believe the amount. And there was more, there was lots, like a lot of different games and stuff that were at the Goodwill. So it's definitely worth checking out. I mean, there was probably 6 or 7 more games that I could have got. They had Smath, which I'm not sure exactly how you play that game, but I have seen it elsewhere. They had a whole bunch of the junior games, like Monopoly Junior and Scrabble Junior. But we have both of those already because we play games quite a bit. They had all kinds of games. They had several sets of dominoes, but I have 2 sets already, so I didn't really need any. But yes, definitely check out the Goodwill in your area, because I found a ton of good stuff there today. And I actually met another mom there that was a homeschool mom, which was a little bit surprising to me, because we went at like 12 o'clock in the afternoon, and a lot of homeschoolers don't even go out during that time, because you always get questions like, why aren't your kids in school? I get that so many times. But she just came up to me at Goodwill and she was like, oh, you must be a homeschooler too. And it was just so refreshing to meet another homeschool mom just out and about, minding our own business, you know, getting our shopping done for the week. And it was definitely awesome. So, and if you guys want me to, I will do a video about what we eat in a week or whatever. Just leave me a comment if you're interested in that. But basically the rundown of it is we don't eat any grains at all. Aside from corn, we may eat corn every once in a while. But yeah, just fruits and veggies, basically. Limited sugar, that kind of stuff. So if you're interested in that kind of video, I will definitely make you guys one. But yeah, I will be doing a video tomorrow about what our theme is for this month. And I have 2 videos. One video will be on the morning basket for this month, and then how everything is redecorated for the month of October. So, because we're going to have all of our harvesty stuff out. So pumpkins and apples and things like that. We're going to have a lot of that stuff out. Leaves, fall leaves, kind of getting our fall decor out and changing it up a little bit from our fishies. The fish are still up today because we had one more book in our morning basket that we needed to go through. So we went ahead and did that book today, and I will be redoing the entire room tonight. So So that's it for my video. I will see you guys tomorrow with a new video. And I will try to be doing at least 5 videos this week. So this is video number 1. And I'll catch you later. Bye.